I just discovered something that might completely change the way you use presets in Lightroom. I know it's made me completely rethink it. So many of you are aware of presets. These can just, in a single click, completely change the way an image looks. However, have you noticed sometimes when you're going through presets, it seems like parts of certain presets seems to stick to the photo and other parts just kind of fade away? I don't know if you've noticed that. So I've noticed this, and I've called these reset presets. Let me show you what I mean. So say, for example, I'm going to apply this preset. So let me demonstrate this to you right now, and then I'm going to show you what to do about it. So a preset can be broken down to as simple as remembering the position of the sliders. So in this case, I created this night preset, and all I've done is I've reduced the temperature and the exposure. That's it. If I reset the temperature, reset the exposure, there's the original image, apply night, or hit reset, hit night. Okay, so here's where it matters. When we go to create a preset, we click on create preset. Now we have the option to turn all these options on. We have the option to turn all of these off. Here's where the misconception comes in. Sometimes people think, well, if I've only made these changes in my photo, then why don't I just check the boxes of those things that I've just changed? This is the big thing. Listen up right now. Whatever I have checked will be replaced by that preset. Whatever is not checked will not change in the preset. Whether or not I've moved the sliders has nothing to do with moving the sliders. Let me demonstrate. So we're going to create this preset. We're going to check none. And the only two things I've changed here are white balance and exposure, right? So we're just going to call this one underscore test, just to keep it simple. So let me create that preset. It's called test. Let me reset my image. And when we click on the test preset, as expected, the temperature and the exposure have been changed. Watch this. If I reset this and I change something else, such as the contrast. Now, when I apply this preset, notice the contrast doesn't change. Now, let me hit the reset. We're going to go back to the test again. Back how we expected it. Now watch this. If I create a preset, I turn on everything, and we call it test, reset, and click create. Okay, let's reset everything. Now let's choose the test reset. First of all, I'm going to take the contrast all the way down like we did before. Hit test reset. Now look at this. It applies the temperature, the exposure, and now it resets the contrast to its default value. So that means if I've got all of these set at a default value and I save those and I check those boxes, it's going to move them back to those zero position. So this is really important to know when you're creating your presets, because this can enable you to create presets that add certain attributes without changing things. For example, say you've spent time doing a white balance on your photograph and you want to apply some light leaks. So if we look at these two light leaks, notice that they're not changing the coloring of the image, no matter what I do to it. So maybe I warm it up. Watch this. Those light leaks are not changing it. See that? And that's because with those, I only checked the radial gradient, which is what creates the light leaks, and nothing else. So this means I can apply a light leak without messing up my color grade. However, if I want to reset it, I've got another light leak. Look at this one. If I roll over this one, doesn't matter where I go, it's going to reset it to this particular setting, because on this one, I checked all the boxes. So that's what I call a reset preset. So you can create some presets that are going to reset everything. You're going to reset your color and apply the effect you want no matter where your photo is. Other ones are going to retain certain things and only add the attributes you want. Now, how can you change a preset from a regular to a reset preset? So in this one here, I can choose it there. I'm going to create a new preset. This is a Light Leaks 2, right? I'll just call it LL2, but then I'm going to put a slash R. So maybe you want to even put an R after so you know if it resets. And what I've done now is I've turned on absolutely everything in here, and we're going to create it, even though we're not using most things. But watch this. Now, if I set my white balance, as you know, the original Light Leaks is not going to change the white balance. But if I go to the one that I've made a reset preset, look at that. Now it resets that to whatever value I wanted. If you want my Lightroom presets, I'll give you a link where you can download them for free. If you're already on our newsletter, just look towards the bottom of every newsletter I send out where it says The Vault, and you can click on there and download them directly. So it's really important to grasp this principle when you're creating and working with presets inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw. It can really take the unpredictability out of there and give you way more control over your presets. So I'm curious, let me know in the comments underneath if you realized this is the way the presets worked, or if you didn't. And by the way, if you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Do me a favor, hit the like button if you enjoyed this. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.